thank you for staying with us. And if you tune in late, Jack Logan is here, founder of Put Down the Guns Now, young people, and Pastor Bobby Bryant, who's here from the Outreach Ministry in Calhoun Falls. And we're talking about violence in our society, and it's particularly about guns, and how we all can be safe and keep our families safe and our kids safe and our schools safe. This is a priority thing that we all should be concerned with.
And you're right, Ms. Denny. This summer has been violent, you know, across America. Just today, I think it was in Delaware, 5 people were shot in a home. Yesterday in Maryland, number of people were shot. The day before that, 15 or 16 people were shot in Chicago. It just goes on. And before, we're reading about these large number of people being shot. Well, I recall sitting here a while back talking about the violence in Chicago with teenagers.
Yeah.
Now it's here. Well, Satan is a busy man.
Yes, he is.
Satan is a busy man. And he's listening to us talk and allowing people to read about all this. We're to pray for those people and pray not just for ourselves. We're to pray for everybody because the blood is one color and that is red.
That's
and we
right.
cannot forget about Jesus. And when I look at people lose a family member to violence, and people run to that and say, oh, I'm so sorry. And then you'll have this other crowd who criticize and post negative comments on social media. Well, they were nothing but old gangbanger. Jesus is not satisfied, happy with that kind of talk, because it's my job, your job, the people out there watching, when they hear violence, to get involved, to help. Like this pastor talked about his outreach ministry down in Calhoun Falls. It's people's jobs, not only just in Calhoun Falls. Those children who he's trying to help are all our children. And those people who have family problems or violence, if they're my age, they're our brothers and sisters in Christ if we're living under one. But people now have rejected Jesus, and they think this paper, which you showed a while ago, is the way to go, and it's not the way to go. It's about a book called B-I-B-L-E.
See, I mean, our country's been in love with guns since the beginning.
Right, and it's not a rich thing. It's not a poor thing. It's not a black thing.
It's not a
white thing.
It's not.
We're going into every subdivision, dealing with every race across the country. It's violence have just taken over.
I know you've recently been in Chicago, haven't you?
Right, yes, we have. But when I thought about, and I had to go back to that little 2-year-old kid down in Lawrence who was beat to death, you know, by his parents and his stepfather. And when I first heard it, and then the first person said to me, said, Jack, that must be a black child. And I hate to talk about this too, but no. That shows that Satan is in the white race, is in the black race, is in the Hispanics. When we go out in the community, you see this everywhere. When we went down to Anderson the other day, when those people down there throwing firecrackers, I think it was on the 4th of July, when that 3-year-old girl was shot. And we drove up down there at 10:45 p.m. at night. Children, 6 and 7, 8, running around, no parenting. That's very disturbing.
Well, it's the breakdown of the family.
It's the breakdown.
It's part of
it goes back to people. We need to get back to the basics. And it's about Jesus Christ and raising your children.
A lot of people out there are going to say it's too late. We can't turn
the
clock back.
It's never too late.
Yes.
The world is like the television show, the soap opera, As the World Turns. And we can always turn it around. And we must go back to the basics and put God first, words first. And we have forgot about that. And that's why we have all this violence going on.
Okay, now, Pastor Bobby, you work with young people.
Yes.
Age 5 all the way through teenage years.
Mm-hmm.
And you try to give them something positive. And many of these kids don't have positive at home.
Mm-hmm.
The problems start at home.
Absolutely. You know, the Bible teaches us that we ought to teach a child that the way that we know how. So we ought to teach them diligently. and so they won't depart away from them. You know, at times when you're teaching a child and they receive it, they might not do it right then and now, but further on down the road, they will remember these things. But if you're not teaching a child these things, and then they goes and get into Corinthian activities and things that would hinder them and cause them to be jailbound in jail or catching a charge, then because they were not taught these things, it would not be with them. And they're not receiving these things. And so one of the things, and to have an impact on a child, it have to start at home. And then we can teach the parents so that they can teach the child. Because the thing is that too many kids is not having supervision among their home. And just as Mr. Jack has said, when he pulled up at late at night, there was no supervision. There was no parenting. That the kids are just going haywire. They just here now, this at night, your child should be at home, in bed, getting ready to go to school or go to church or go to some kind of program to have a positive effect on their life. And that is wrong with some of the ways that we're having among the communities and in our home. It's the impact that we're not providing for our children. And we're going to need that because if they're not taught these things, then when they go among the world, they're not going to, you know, reciprocate to some of these things. They're not going to receive these things when something happened to them. And we all are not devil-proof. Things going to happen to us. The devil is not going to discriminate. What color you are, what race you are, it will not discriminate. Whether you're at that place or this place, or you're going to be used by this thing, or you're going to be used by that thing, you know, we all going to be in a place at some time that we're going to make bad decision. Mm-hmm. But bad decision reflects off how we've been taught. I made bad decision in my life. But because how I was raised and how I was taught, I was able to reciprocate from those things that I was taught. And because I had mentors, I had pastors, I had people that was a positive, you know, reflection in my life that was able to guide me in different direction. And that's what we got to do. We got to guide kids and youth in different direction where they're from. If we're not guiding them, then they're going to continue to go in that path. And that path can be in a negative way.
Okay. So we have a tremendous obligation if we are knowledgeable in the least and we have had a good background or a good bringing up or a home life where there's stability. If you have that, pass it on to somebody else. Yes. And it isn't always easy.
No, ma'am, it's not.
I was at Turbyville Correction Institution 2 weekends ago, and it was on Father's Day, and I let the inmates speak. And 4 or 5 of those inmates said the reason why they did their crime, they came to prison very early. They hurt so bad by not having a father in the house. They knew right from wrong, but they was hurting because they needed their father, and some of their mothers would not let them have any contact with their father, and that hurt them. And then there was some where their fathers just neglected them. And to sit there and watch those men give their testimony. And some of them have small children. One of them have a small child, and he talked about how he, when his son come to see him in prison, how he tried to instruct him and direct him what he needed.
That's right.
As a child. Again, I'll say to any mother out there now, let that father of that boy be in that boy's life, because that father can help us stop some of this violence. Mm-hmm.
Now, we do have a phone number, and I'll keep the information here. If anybody out there wants to get in touch with Jack Logan or Pastor Bobby Bryant at Calhoun Falls, I can put them. But you would be willing to go into a community and talk to people?
Yes.
And help people to get something going?
Absolutely.
And have our churches failed our young people?
Yes.
Yes, tremendously.
Okay. We can't fix families that are broken. You can't go by and here's a family that's broken and you don't have the power to fix it.
Mr. Dennis, it's,
but amen. Where have we fallen?
Okay, I'm going to go back to the churches. Pastor is looking at numbers in the pews. Is that fair to say? They're looking at numbers instead of going out there doing the right thing. It's not about fame for the pastor. The pastors have jobs to do and responsibilities Amen. To do and to teach that book as it is written.
That's right.
And don't twist it and turn it just to get little Jack to come back to next Sunday. No, you teach it as it is written, the same way your English teacher teach you grammar in school. And that's the problem in our churches today, in some of the churches.
I'm grateful to both of you for what you've Amen. Shared with us today. And if anybody out there wants to get in touch with Jack Logan, put the guns down, no young people, and also with Pastor Bobby Bryant Amen. From Calhoun Falls,
yes.
I can put you in touch with them, and you are committed
yes.
to working with young people, and you want to do an outreach, not just where you are, but
yes.
to spread the yes. good news that we can do better in the Absolutely. United States of America Amen. For our young people.
Absolutely. One thing I just yeah. want to add to yeah. that is that...
Because we're out of time.
Okay.
Make it quick.
An outreach. It's just not multiplied just on a Sunday.
Okay.
But this is a Monday through okay. Sunday.
Monday through Sunday. We got to get out there every single
Monday
day.
Monday through Sunday.
Bless
That's
you.
Right.
Stay happy. Amen. We'll see you next time.
Amen.